As you can imagine, the BMW 7 Series, the flagship of the brand BMW, is something very special to us. It's special to us as designers because it represents its own set of challenges and, if you will, assignments. It is the flagship of the brand BMW. That means there's a certain presence, a certain status, a certain elegance that is very important for this vehicle. But it is a BMW, so it has to be the most dynamic, the most athletic, the most precise machine in this market segment. And this is what we've tried to do, and hopefully you see it as well in this sketch, which was really one of the initial sketches we had that pretty much states the statement of this car as you see it today. Now, you've heard already that our goal was to achieve modern luxury. And modern luxury, yes, it means sort of anticipating what the customer wants before they even know what they want. Modern luxury has a lot to do with individualization, being able to curtail to every customer's unique demand. But on the other hand as well, for us designers, modern luxury means almost an obsessive attention to detail. And you'll see, hopefully later as I go on, this obsessive attention to detail, to every little aspect, particularly in the interior. But I'd like to show you one image before we actually look at the whole car, for one thing in particular. This image is there and it shows you the car with open doors, and inside you can see the lighting, the mood lighting, and the contour lighting inside the car. We'll go a bit later in detail about that. That was a very important aspect that we played much stronger in this generation than we have ever done before on any 7 Series or any BMW. But the second and very important thing, which you can see quite well here as well on the floor, is the light carpet. And the light carpet is a small thing. It actually has a function. It actually illuminates the floor below you, so if there is water, you don't get wet at nighttime when you enter the car. But it's also a symbol. It's really a metaphorical red carpet that rolls out in front of your feet before you enter the 7 Series. And entering the 7 Series is something special, should be something special, and that is why we created this little innovation that we believe adds a lot and is a symbol for this attention to detail. But presence, being very important, presence really plays the major role, or comes into play mostly when you look at the front. The front of a 7 Series, the front of a BMW, is something essential through the kidneys mostly. So here you see a 7 Series with very large kidneys, very proud kidneys, very upright kidneys. Maybe the highest or biggest kidneys we've ever done so far, definitely on the 7 Series. So that helps presence, but also it's a BMW, and a BMW needs to be sported, even if it is a 7 Series. So there's a lot of width. The kidneys and headlamps are graphically connected the way you've seen them before, but combining width and status and height, we believe, gives exactly the character that we want a 7 Series to have. But we added a little feature that is actually as well here, a pretty symbolic feature. The kidneys are most of the time closed. They're actually not open when you're going at high speeds because you don't really need it. You don't need them to be. It's actually better for drag coefficient when they're closed. But when the engine is working hard and needs that air to come in, they open up. And you can see in that image behind me that you literally experience these kidneys opening and closing. And that is an innovation where the heart of BMW is in terms of design. The kidneys are maybe the most important symbol that a BMW has in exterior design. In the front, we actually went further as well in terms of design with headlamps. You recognize the double round headlamps, but here as well, for the first time, we connected the interior circle to the kidneys with function. So it's not only graphically connected, it's also functionally connected. But there's one little feature in this image that you see, is that these blue stripes here represent the laser headlamps. And as you probably know, we are the first to introduce laser headlamps on the i8, which are on the road today. And we will bring this innovation as well for the first time in this market segment on the 7 Series. That being said, It is not available in the US, at least not at this point. So we're proud of it, and we'll be more proud if we manage to bring it to the US. But our engineers are working pretty hard to with the US government to make it available here in the US market. Another image here up on the wall is to talk about proportions. I think you also all know typical BMW proportions have a short front overhang, a long hood, a cabin that is rearward in its placing, and that is very typical BMW, very essential to BMW proportion. But for a 7 Series, it plays an even bigger role because presence also plays, or let me put it this way, presence from the side has, it comes into effect a lot through elegance. And these proportions, which we worked very hard with our engineers to have, are essential to that aspect of elegance. The long hood, the rearward cabin, the flowing C-pillar, that is typical BMW, typical 7 Series. And here, we believe that we've done it better than we've ever done it on a 7 Series. Another aspect about the design of 7 Series from the side, it is actually two lines. You have one line that connects the headlamps to the tail lamps, and you have one line at the bottom that goes from the air breather behind the front wheel all the way to the rear bumper. That line at the bottom has been, if you will, made even clearer because we have a chrome finisher that connects that air breather to the rear, making the car also look leaner. And it is a 7 Series, it has presence, it has status, but it's also a lightweight car, and we wanted that to also be visible into the design. Now, this obsession, let's say, with detail, I've here sort of took three examples that are very important. The air breather I mentioned at the bottom, the air breather is there. It has a functional input when it comes to drag coefficient, but it's also a tool we use, or a feature we use to create more value in the exterior design. So here you have a functional aspect that has been amplified or augmented through an ornament, a chrome line. But the way BMW does ornaments, we don't do it just for the sake of it. We only do it if it actually reinforces a function. And that's what you see here in this car. The second aspect, a little thing, but a very effective thing, is a mirror. The mirror is actually here anchored just at the bottom of this chrome strip. It is much lighter optically, and it's also much better acoustically. It is, and in terms of drag coefficient. And this is the most quiet mirror we've ever done. And as you know, on a car that is so quiet, it's very important that every detail has been really worked at to the last millimeter. And this is one of the examples. And finally, one aspect that I'm particularly very proud of is the fact that the Hofmeister, which is as well, if you will, at the heart of BMW design, spec particularly for the side, is one piece. And it's a little thing. Usually we have one piece at the top and one piece at the bottom connected with a 1 millimeter shut line. But that 1 millimeter shut line, to be honest, is something that we really wanted to get rid of. So we invested as well. It is not an easy piece to construct into one piece that goes from the B pillar to the C pillar and back. And that, again, pays a lot of respect to something that is very important in the tradition of BMW. The rear, here as well, status is very important, particularly on the Autobahn, where we hope most of our competitors will only be seeing the rear of a BMW. The car is actually pretty much to the millimeter as wide as today's car, but it looks much wider, at least in our opinion, and tomorrow you'll probably be able to compare that, due to a few things, actually very simple things. First of all, of course, we have only the best available technology, full LED tail lamps, which allowed us to make the tail lamps much narrower than they are today. And the rest is really about simple, clear line work, very horizontal, very clear, very taut lines, create a lot of width, and as well a lot of lightweight. Now the interior, I mentioned it before, the interior is something where we worked really very hard to really push the game further. Ian mentioned it, I think we did really make huge steps, not only in terms of design, but I think as a company, in terms of the level of fit and finish and quality that we've built. definitely the best 7 Series ever built at that level, and most probably the best BMW ever built at that level. And that has a lot to do with the way we treat a lot of details, and I'll go into that a bit further. But another aspect which Ian mentioned as well before is comfort. Of course, BMW is a car where the driver plays the primary role, but we know a lot of our customers don't drive the car all the time. Sometimes they are being driven. Therefore, we pay particular attention to the rear. And the rear has a lot to do with also enjoying the act of being into a BMW through comfort, through well-being, through being surrounded with just quality and refinement around you. Now, some of the details that actually represent why or how we achieve that quality. The buttons here are actually galvanized buttons, meaning that there's a thin layer of metal on every button. It is a very thin layer, but it is real metal. Therefore, whatever you touch will be a real authentic material. So it will be the way metal is, cold on a cold day and warm on a warm day. The same way the door handle is, because the door handle as well is real metal, as you would expect of a car, a BMW, in that category. The touch command in the rear, Paul will go more into detail later about that, but the touch command is really also there symbolically to show that we are actually at the highest level of the consumer electronics world in a car, the way probably no other car has been at this point. So you can actually control everything in the rear through the touch command, where today you have control. Finally, two little examples. The bottom left image shows you the bottom of the C-pillar, and the bottom of the C-pillar is actually leather and wood. So why would you actually have leather, which is very expensive for us to manufacture, in a place where you don't see it if you're sitting in the rear? Well, the fact is that you might not see it, but you will always perceive it and maybe touch it when you enter and exit a car. So we wanted to pay particular attention to every corner of the car, so that when you enter or exit the car, you don't see anything or touch anything you don't feel is worthy of a BMW 7 Series. Another detail that basically tries to achieve the same goal is this feature here in the B-pillar. You can experience it in the car, is a mood lighting. And that mood lighting is there, and it's touch control mood lighting. It obviously gives you the ability to tune the lighting the way you want it. But it's also there to hide something that is necessary, and that's the rubber sealing between the door and the B-pillar. But we wanted to make sure that when you're sitting in the rear, everything in your field of vision is about quality and it's about refinement. And that is what a BMW 7 Series should be. So that way it makes sure you don't see anything you shouldn't have to. And finally, the character of the car. We talked about individualization. We know very much that the 7 Series has different markets. It's sold in different parts of the world where different cultures have different understanding of luxury, or maybe where our customers have, on average, different age. And therefore, we made sure that we offered the proper bandwidth within the character of the BMW 7 Series from launch, from start of production. And what you see here, obviously, is the M Sport pack. It was very important to us that we create a very strong character for the M Sport pack, very sporty, very much recognizable as an M, and you will see this car as well tomorrow. And finally, the top of the top, if you want the ultimate luxury at every level, you can have a BMW 7 Series individual from launch, and you can see it here with the best leather we can offer, the best leathers, the best veneers, best woods, the best metals, and also very important, very intricate stitching, which is something as well that we've never done to that level on any BMW, and something that we pay particular attention to, and that, I guess, you can see that as well tomorrow. So there you have it. In a few words, the design of the next BMW 7 Series.